Black Beatles in the city, be back immediately to confiscate the money.
Race girl, wow, my will.
You sent flowers, but you said you didn't receive.
That girl is a real crowd please. Small world, all her friends know of me. Young bull living like an old geese. Quick release the cash, watch it fall slowly. Frat girl still trying to get even. Haters mad for whatever reason. Smoke in the air, binge drinking. They lose it when the DJ drops the knee.
All right, knock it off. Let's go. You know, we are just, we're cutting edge. I mean, we do everything first. I mean, how many people have done the mannequin challenge before we did?
You know what? I've just seen a couple of these. Explain this to me. What, who started it? What does it mean? Does anybody know?
I mean, probably the same people that like the Harlem Shake. Did you ever do that?
Yes.
Okay. I don't think that I did that even.
Yeah,
you
did?
We did?
We did the Harlem
Oh yeah,
Shake.
We did. We did in our old location at the Ken Gray Ken Gray Museum. That was excellent.
I can't believe you said it. We weren't supposed to be in there that night.
Oh, I know. We did kind of break in. Okay. Yeah, it was fun. Okay, but here's the deal. Something funny came up the other day I thought I would share with you.
Okay.
You know, we're produced by Growing Media. It's a marketing ad company. If you need help, that was shameless. But anyway, we talked about this digital targeted marketing. You know, if you go in and you type into Google that you're looking for whatever, every time you get back on your computer, what? There's gonna be an ad for that right there. Okay.
Sure.
So Rob points out, he goes, you know, it's also fun to look at when you type in something that you might be interested in. It's like people who bought this also bought this.
Yes.
Okay. So it was interesting when we typed in tarp. Okay. So if you buy a tarp, people who buy tarps are also buying duct tape, a shovel,
rope,
trash bags. Can you believe it?
Seriously.
Oh.
That stuff came up.
That's scary.
You know what? When you Google Julie, here's what comes up.
Wait.
When you Google Julie, here's what comes up.
Yes.
George Strait, flowers, chocolates, caviar, wine. What would come up if we Googled you?
A whole lot of mess.
Pictures from Panama City Beach.
A whole lot of mess. Yeah, don't Google it. It's not good. But it is scary because in this day and age, they're always watching. They know what you're doing on your computer.
Isn't that something?
Yeah, I think Siri's reporting to somebody. Like if you talk on your phone, she's telling people about you.
Also too, if you got the apps to where, I'm just gonna throw it out there, they're not a sponsor.
Just throw it out.
But I'd like for Old Charlie's to be a sponsor.
Old Charlie's,
I've got the Old Charlie's little app on my phone.
For what?
Every time I pass Old Charlie's, a deal comes on.
Oh, see?
Every time I pass Old Charlie's, hey, 30% off today.
Are you tempted?
Yeah.
You are?
Yeah, and I go.
Yeah.
Every time I get that little message.
My last experience at Old Charlie's, well, I don't even know if they do it anymore, but I had started—
Free Pie Wednesday?
Girl, I had started a diet. And I go to Old Charlie's thinking I'm gonna get the salad and be good. They're like, oh yeah, it's free pie night. Free pie night, what kind would you like? And I'm like, I mean, I had to start the diet, obviously, a day later.
So. Here's what I do. I sit there on free pie night, mm-hmm. which is Wednesdays, and my family gets their pie. By then, we're too full to eat it. So
okay.
we get it to take home.
We get
the pie.
Okay.
And then I'll look over at, it's usually a grandma and grandpa. And
okay.
They're really full and they don't want theirs. And I'll say, you want a banana and an apple? And I take lots of pies home.
Julie, you do not.
Okay, just
I want
one
to
time.
Apologize to what? All those couples she has harassed.
You know what? One time I did. It was waste of pie. Eat it. They didn't want it.
But then you told them what to order because you knew it was like premeditated.
Oh
right?
Yeah. They knew what to order for me.
All right, we have an enormous show. Like a lot going on. You know?
Gigantua. Is that one?
I don't think that's a word.
What's that? What am I trying to say?
Gargantuan?
Ginormous?
No. Gargantuous.
I think
show.
I said that, yes. It's what?
Slightly sizable.
Slightly
No, to me, that's not
slightly.
Big.
Yeah.
I'm slightly sizable.
All right, we better get to it. We'll be right back.
I'm here today, and all I hear is how I'm chasing crazy dreams. They'll see, 'cause I've got perfect songs and melodies just waiting to come out of me, and you'll sing along like, oh, oh. Fancy words, clever lines, and tales that take you back in time, and you'll sing along like, oh, oh. Everyone will know. They should have believed in me.
Should have believed, baby.
You're watching The Spiel. Prairie Farms presents Did You Know with Chef Rob.
The new Chef Splendor sour cream dips from Prairie Farms. They're not just for dipping anymore. Use them as an incredibly flavorful sandwich spread, a great pasta sauce enhancer, and they come in three flavors: spicy ranch, roasted red pepper, and tzatziki, all made with real milk and cream, blended with vegetables and spices. It's just that simple. Check out our website at prairiefarms.com.
At the Bank of Herrin, we know that between family and work, it can be a challenge to find the time to take care of things like going to the bank. And really, what you need is a way to do your banking on the go. Well, we've got good news. With the Bank of Herrin mobile banking app, you can manage debit cards, find bank locations, monitor account activity, even make a deposit. Just a few of the ways our mobile banking app can save you a trip to the bank. We'd love for you to come see us, but now you don't have to. The Bank of Herrin. It's not just a bank, it's mobile banking.
You're watching The Spiel.
And welcome back to The Spiel. One of my favorite segments. We're going to put our hands in here and do some stuff today. From Buds to Blooms Florist, it is Stacy Bowles. So glad to have you.
You know, it's not hard for you to make friends, is it? Because when you show up with stuff like this, we're friends.
Right.
Already. Yeah, absolutely. It's beautiful and it brightened our day. And if we get to dive in and like make a creation, that's going to be a lot of fun too.
Yes.
And how long have you been a designer?
I've designed for about 18 years.
Okay. Wow.
Yes.
So you're kind of, you do a decent job then, I guess.
You okay?
I try.
Well, when a person approaches design of a floral arrangement, should they take the client into consideration? Is it just the overall outcome? How do you approach each project?
Actually, I actually like to ask everybody what color preference they like, because mm-hmm. that's like a big deal for people. Mm-hmm. If they know their flowers, I try to, you know, ask them what flowers they want in particular, because sometimes they want a rose and, you know, you might put something other than a rose in there yeah. if you don't clarify that for them. Yeah. So mainly what they want color-wise and flower-wise.
So you hate to see people like me come in where I say, you know,
do you have any carnations?
No. No, kidding. I'll say, kidding. I want some of that purple stuff over here by that yellow and then bit of green.
Sure.
You hate that, don't you?
Well, you know what? It's creativity, so we have to put our minds together and make it work.
Yeah, yeah. Well, let's get in here. Let's do something.
What are we making today?
Right. Today we're going to use, it's just basically an antique bow, like get from grandma.
Oh.
So whenever we're done with our flower arrangement, we can take it back out and have a bowl.
Okay.
So, and we do keep these kind of at the shop. We get them from different area places. So if you come in and want an antique bowl, we have them.
Mm-hmm. Hey, and that's not plastic. That's real.
I think that's a big thing now in gift giving. You know, everybody loves to get flowers, but once you have to toss them out, it's like, okay, the memory perhaps fades, but to put it in something like this, so every time, you know, they use it, they're going to think about that time they got the arrangement. That's a great idea.
Exactly. So first of all, we're going to get a piece of Oasis, and I've soaked this. It's already wet for us.
Oasis?
Yeah, it's called Oasis. It's kind of like a wet foam. So we'll put that down in there. You can feel it. It's kind of squishy. Mm-hmm. And then this is floral tape. It's waterproof. Mm-hmm. And that's going to hold our arrangement down in our bowl.
Okay.
Just put it on this side, and we'll just bring it across and tape it. Usually try to just make an X across it.
Okay. And that's just to hold this in place. Okay.
Just to hold it in place so when you're carrying it out or moving it, it doesn't dump or spill anywhere.
Okay.
So basically, first thing first, we will put our greens in.
Uh-huh.
Greens.
You always start with the
greens. It's like a salad.
That's right.
Make
start with the greens.
There you go.
And this is what we call leather's leaf. Mm-hmm. It's just kind of like a little ferny leaf there.
Leather's leaf.
Mm-hmm. And I usually try to cut it in about three spots.
Okay.
depending on the size of the arrangement. Usually one in the middle, and then we go off the sides.
I think that's where people drop the ball many times. They think, okay, we just bought this hole like that. Let's just jab it in there. You
exactly.
Know, people don't think to cut it
to
up
cut,
and use it that
definitely.
Way. Yeah.
So
makes a big difference.
Yeah,
do you just normally jab the hole?
Yeah, mine hangs out.
Oh, definitely. And you really want to make sure that you leave some open spaces, because obviously this oasis is not real big.
Right.
So once you get all your stems in there, when you get to your final, it's hard to get stuff down in.
Sure.
So you don't have to fill it all the way full at the beginning. You mm-hmm. can always come back in later and fill it.
And there's
greens.
Really no rhyme or reason here.
Nope. You just kind of stick it in and fill it up. So that was Leather's Leaf. I always like to try to add three greens to what I'm doing.
Three greens. Oh, mm-hmm. I like this. This
and
is nice.
This is called Huckleberry.
Yes.
Yeah. Just like it comes up.
It looks like the switch I used to have to pick in the yard they spanked
yeah.
me with.
I could see Rita getting this after you.
Definitely. And it's kind of like a stick. I mean, it's stick. It's hard, so it sticks in there. So then once we've got this, we want to go for our height.
Okay.
So we want to get our center point. And I brought
the bottle
in
washers.
The bottle washes.
Boom. How'd I know? Yeah. I knew it was going to go there.
In the center, I always like to do it in threes.
Yes.
Threes is kind of like a focal point for you.
Yes.
And then we're going to come in with our pop, which is going to be in our segment. We're going to use, this is what we call a spider mum.
Spider mum. Mm-hmm.
And these are like a lime green. So when these come in, they come in with a net on them. And mm-hmm. if you were to purchase them, you don't want to pull the net backwards. You want to pull it off this way so your pop.
Oh.
Okay.
Those are really
then you
pretty.
Just spread them out gently. It's not going to hurt to touch
it looks like
them.
A spider.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
So then we're gonna
do you think that's why it's called?
Spider mum.
Spider mum.
Okay.
Do they come in different colors?
They do. They come in yellow, purple, white, orange. Just kind of. So then once we've got our height, we're going to do one this way, and we're going to come our pop out at us.
Okay.
So now we're going to come in with a filler, which this is called ostomaria.
Mm-hmm. Did you know that?
I mean, I'd heard it before, but yeah.
Ostomaria is one of the longest lasting flowers. Mm-hmm. When it comes in, it's really tight, but you could have these on your counter for at least 2 weeks.
Yeah.
So there's kind of like our filler to give us a little bit of color.
Love that.
Then we're gonna go in, and these are roses, and I brought these in because they're a little bit older because I wanted them to fan out almost like a cabbage rose.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So it's gonna give us a pop. So
and the name?
These are hybrid Angelina.
Also known as the antique rose?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
You can use it.
Hey.
Yeah.
How come? Okay, yeah, there's thorns.
It's Angelina. It's named after me. Sort of. Not.
Well, you named this one after me today.
Yes.
Sure.
The Julie.
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 The coral Julie.
Ooh, hey,
yeah,
I like
that's a new one there. That's
a seller.
Definitely.
Top seller.
Got it.
How often should you change the water or?
I like to add water because when it goes in the oasis,
okay.
I like to add water to it. You know, every morning, daily, it's going to help you freshen it up.
Okay.
And once you've had it for like a week, if your flowers are still looking pretty, if you'll take a cap full of bleach and pull it in
bleach?
The side, mm-hmm, it kills the algae inside the oasis to keep your flowers from dying.
Who
really?
Yes. Never heard of that.
See, I had heard of it. Did people use aspirin at one point?
Uh-huh.
Aspirin,
yes.
Or then that
yes.
little salt stuff, that, of course, that'll come with flowers sometimes, but
yep.
bleach?
Bleach.
I never find that stuff works real well.
I don't
think it
does.
Yeah.
Definitely. So I'm going to go ahead and put this curly willow.
Curly willow.
We're going to put that in there so we can go ahead
perfect.
And fit it down
yeah,
in.
Love that.
Gives it a little more height.
Now this would be an expensive arrangement. I mean, when you bring in those roses and all the coffee beans and stuff, perhaps, you know, a little bit more affordable.
This arrangement's probably going to run you anywhere from 75 to 80. Something
that's typical.
Around that.
Yeah,
you
that's
know, like
that's
an
typical.
Average arrangement.
I was thinking more. It's
really?
So big and beautiful. Yes,
yeah.
I was.
I'm going to show you a little trick that a lot of people like to do. And these are what they call tie leaves. Just a little pop of leaf, kind of pull it off to the
tie
side.
Leaf, okay.
Mm-hmm. It's a tie leaf. And what I like to do is kind of stroke it a little bit, make it come under, and then I bring it back here. And I'm
we've got to get it on this. Look at this, Jason. It's
cut
a trick.
This at an angle.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to poke a hole back here.
Oh, this is
and that
cool.
kind of makes a bow for us. We're not going to put a bow on this arrangement because I'm going to use the tie leaf as my bow.
I love that. That was worth the whole segment right
so
there.
That goes in there, and we'll do one more that way, and then we'll
that's
have one come
awesome.
Off.
That's
awesome. Wow.
So it goes down in.
Mm-hmm.
Pop it again. We use that one a little loose. So
bravo. Out. You win the award.
Yay!
Floral Design of the Year.
That was good.
That was excellent. I think a big thing in floral design too is just don't be afraid to get in there and play. And people always say, well, I can't do that. I'll mess it up. Or, you know, it's,
wow.
Would you look at that?
Look at that.
Ladies.
All the way around. A++.
Thank you. Good job. I'm going to also tell you a little bit about Leaf Shine.
Okay.
Leaf Shine you can buy, we buy it to put on our finished arrangements because mm-hmm. it obviously is going to make them shine bright. If you have household plants or anything, you can come in and get a can of Leaf Shine. It's like the old days, you used to take mayonnaise and clean the leaves. Mm-hmm. That's what Leaf Shine does.
It so it doesn't hurt cleans. Anything?
Nope. We'll spray
I mean,
it
you're
on
not
hands.
You're not supposed to ingest it like as it's
yeah.
happening. Ooh,
how would it look on
that.
Here? Hairspray kind of a shine?
Oh,
no?
Well,
okay. That way it's always
wet looking.
What do you think,
Stacy?
I don't know.
Here, let's try it on.
No, we're good. And really quickly before we get out here, you know, you mentioned doing this
yeah.
for quite some time. What was the motivation and what made you decide on this as a
I had a girlfriend that really couldn't really afford the wedding. And she's like, we can do this.
Oh.
So we kind of pulled together and we did her wedding. And ever since then, it was kind of something I like to do and
That's
fell
awesome.
Right into it.
That's awesome.
I actually went to dental assisting school, worked in that for like 7.5 years in oral surgery.
And she went,
not
nails,
as
yes.
flowers.
No, yeah.
Wow.
So that's how it came about.
Well, good
definitely.
For you, because I think you definitely chose the right road. Very
thank
talented,
you.
Very
thank
talented.
You, thank
and we'll
you.
Be right back.
Coming up on the Spiel.
Calling right when you can.
I'm here at the special Boston red carpet premiere of the new film Patriots Day.
We debated, you know, is it too soon? But you think about what happened in Cairo on Sunday and what continues to happen all over the world, it's not soon enough.
Hey, Chef Rob here, introducing our new Chef Splendor dips from Prairie Farms. They come in spicy ranch, roasted red pepper, and my favorite, tzatziki. Made with 100% real sour cream, were crafted in small batches, all natural ingredients, no artificial growth hormones added, and gluten-free. Look for us today. Check out our website at prairiefarms.com.
I have had trouble all my life with anxiety and depression. There are so many other people out there like me who deal with this every single day. My main goal is to get the mental health degree and start my own practice. I want to go out there and help them.
Three Rivers College, success starts here.
What are you doing?
I'm getting ready.
In the store?
Clean up aisle 6.
Have you seen these bathroom displays?
At Southside Lumber, our professional design team can help you create the bathroom you've always wanted. Call or stop by and see for yourself.
This is my dream bathroom.
More than just lumber. Southside Lumber.
You'll know you're in Shawnee Forest Country when the hills rise up to meet you. When the fruit of the land seems to be waiting for you to pick it. Where at the end of every path, you'll find another reason to raise a toast. The Shawnee National Forest is home to miles of unbelievable natural wonders, adventure, wineries, and unique places to stay. That's how you'll know you're in Shawnee Forest Country. Plan your getaway at southernmostillinois.com.
From its indelible fade-resistant ink to its leak-proof aluminum valve and trademark pocket clip, there is a reason the Ideal Mark marking pen is a favorite in the construction world. As the only all-metal marker in the industry, this high-performance valve-action pen features a finer marking tip for precise marks every time. So when precision counts, make your mark with the Ideal Mark by Diagraph.
The Spiel presents You're On, 100% original new music.
Hi, my name is Chelley Odle with Chelley Odle Ministries, and this song is called Why Didn't I?
Chances I could have taken, words I could have said. Why didn't I prayers I could have prayed, lives I could have changed. Why didn't I? Every moment's here for a moment, then it's gone. I'm gonna live like I need to live, love like I need to love. Don't wanna let a day go by where I ask why didn't I make the most of every minute I have in this life. I wanna live so I never ask why. Why didn't I? Hey, time I should have spent with those God blessed me with, why didn't I? I should have held my ground instead of backing down. Oh, why didn't I? I gotta get my heart to realize sometimes you gotta fight. I'm gonna live like I need to live, love like I need to love. Don't wanna let a day go by where I ask why didn't I make the most of every minute that I have in this life. I wanna live so I never ask why. Why didn't I? Give hope to the hopeless, strength to the weak, reach out to the helpless, lend a hand to those in need. Give me a heart that really cares about all the broken and the down and out. I wanna make a difference, so God help me. I'm gonna live like I need to live. I'm gonna love like I need to love, 'cause this world don't have enough. I'm gonna live like I need to live, love like I need to love. I never let a day go by where I don't try to get it right. I'm gonna make the most of every minute that I have in this life. I'm gonna live so I never ask why. Why didn't I? Oh yeah, why didn't I?
Hi, Dr. Jones, John Shimkus. Hi, ladies. I'm John. Good to see you.
Ah, he's a man. That's right.
What vocations like this provide is really the doctor-patient relationship, medical records, and the wholeness aspect. Healthcare is very complicated and complex. People in rural, small-town America, they don't have the access that everyone should have, which is primary care.
People know if I go there, I'll get seen.
Using an emergency room for your health care needs, it's costly, it's inefficient, and then sometimes the gaps of care are lost because you're just dealing with the immediate health care event, not the wellness of the whole individual. And that's what clinics do, provide that needed opportunity for folks to have access to care and really build on that doctor-patient relationship and medical home. Folks can get access and advice and consultations with some of the best.
We love making new friends. Visit us online at facebook.com/spielon.
Chelley Odle Ministries, you're on, and my goodness, such important music. Everything that you sing about, there seems to be a message there.
Thank you.
Oh.
Yes. That was good stuff.
It made us cry.
Oh.
And we're hard people.
We are hard.
It was amazing. Oh. Tell me how you got started. Have you always sang?
I've been singing since I was 2 years old. My first recollection of singing was on a rocking horse on our old farmhouse that my parents had. And my dad he was originally from Missouri, but had moved to Bakersfield, California. We had family there. And he had sung and had been in studio with Buck Owens and Merle Haggard before they were ever legends. And then, of course, got homesick and came home. And then our life started then. My dad's always been a singer. My parents had their own little country music show when I was a kid.
Were you in it?
I wasn't. No, they always tried to get me to, but I would never do it. So honestly, I always sang my whole life, but I never really started pursuing it until I started going to church and I got saved. And there seemed to be a purpose for it to me at that point.
About what age was that?
That was about 14. And then I could tell I started doing worship in church, and then I could tell, I could just feel a drawing that there was more to it. I felt like God had more for me with that gift that He had given me. So I ended up doing worship in church, and then, like I said, it just grew, and then I felt that longing or that calling to do something more and started truly praying about that and seeking God for it. Mm-hmm. We had a prophecy minister come into our church that night and basically just shared with me what he felt in the spirit about what God was going to do with my ministry. Mm-hmm. And he said, you're asking for an expansion in your ministry and God's going to give it to you. And so he did. And from about that time, I just started praying for God's opportunities, and he started opening one door right after another. And
he has the best plans.
He does. It really does. Yeah.
He's so much better than our own. Exactly. So much better. But you know, and that's really, I've been singing my whole life. But it really didn't start sparking or doing anything until I really started using it for God and for His glory and for His kingdom, and He just started moving from there.
You know, and right now it seems like perhaps it's a perfect time because Christian music is so mainstream now. Mm-hmm. You know, it's widely accepted, right along with mm-hmm. hip hop and country. Mm-hmm. Do you find that are you seeing more doors open for you? Are you seeing more opportunities because more and more people are asking for it?
I think so, yeah. I think that there's different genres of Christian music, just like country is a genre or pop is a genre.
Sure.
So there's different levels of genre in country music or in Christian music as well. I mean, you have worship music, and then you have contemporary, mm-hmm. then you have Christian country, then you've got Southern gospel.
Sure.
So you kind of fit somewhere in between that stage. And there are, I think a lot of it, their churches are very, I don't want to say strict, but they kind of have their own preference.
Sure.
You know, so that contemporary is what's really mainstream now. A lot on the East Coast and some of the Southern states really love that Southern gospel, which is more your quartet style.
Did you like that? I love it all.
Okay. I really do. Yeah. I grew up on country music, my parents, but when I got introduced to church and when I got saved, it was Southern gospel. That's really kind of where that I don't know where my experience in Christian music came from. But then as I've grown, and of course the genres have grown and expanded, I mean, I love country music because that's what I was raised on, but I want to do it for a purpose and serve God. So really my genre is Christian country or inspirational country. So. Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure with your father growing up in country music and you all your life, you probably like the older country music a little better than the new country music.
I do. There was even a group in there. I'm not crazy about it now, but like 90s and 2000 era, I liked that because mm-hmm. it was going a little more poppy. Mm-hmm. And of course, I respect the older country as well. I'll sit and listen to that sometimes, and I'm like, oh my goodness, that's...
It just brings back your memories.
It does. It really does. It absolutely does.
Well, you can take me to church anytime you want, because every word that you sang, I mean, first of all, you can connect to it, the story. Is that essential for you when you choose a song? It has to be there. It has to deliver
absolutely,
that.
Yeah, absolutely. And I was looking for a song that wasn't worshipy, you know, mm-hmm. worship song, where sometimes worship songs have a little bit of redundancies and they kind of say the same thing. I don't necessarily want to do that in an album. I want to be able to have a story, mm-hmm. again, that people can connect with. And again, it's about the people. I mean, to God, it's about the people.
Yeah.
And so you've got to be able to connect with them on a specific level. And worship music is really more for the church, the people who have experienced. But these songs are for people who may not necessarily be churched or have an experience
the unchurched, absolutely.
Or a background in church, but yet it gives them some kind of something, knowing there's something bigger than they are.
Sure.
And that's really the purpose.
How can folks find your music?
They can find me online at ChelleyOdle.com, and I do spell my name a little bit differently. It's C-H-E-L-L-E-Y and O-D-L-E.com. So it's real simple. As long as you type in Chelley Odle with a C or Chelley with a C, you'll find me. Okay. They can find me online. I have a website, Facebook. I'd love for people to like my Facebook page or follow my Facebook page, shoot me messages, text messages. I mean, you know, anything just to communicate and get connected.
Yeah. That second song, we were just talking this morning, Julie has some issues. Like her daughter is about ready for college. She still tucks her in at night. She does her, I mean, she's going to have to cut the cord eventually.
Yeah.
But this song, yeah. I mean, talk about the connectability. And you said it plays with so many facets of life mm-hmm. because for you, for instance, your son, there were two phases already mm-hmm. that it's played. Talk a little bit yeah. about that.
Well, the first phase is whenever I first got this song as a demo, my son was getting ready to graduate high school in about yeah. a year. And yeah. so it really just kind of closed in on me. It just spoke to me so much, and then I knew that if it spoke to me at that way, that it's going to speak to so many other moms.
You spoke to me.
And then now my son is married and has his first baby, so it speaks to me on a completely different level now.
Yeah.
And it's an amazing song, and we actually just did a concert with Jason Crabb. I don't know if you've ever heard of him.
Yeah.
Grammy award-winning Jason. Yeah, we just did a concert with him, and I sang this song and had some media behind it mm-hmm. and it was my children as they grew, and then all of a sudden the wedding pictures with my son and his wife, and then her pregnancy pictures, and then all of a sudden the baby at the end. So it just kind of showed what the song meant to me through the fruition of their lives.
I'm glad I wasn't there for that.
I'd have
been on the
video.
Floor just scrolling. You want to give props to this guy?
Yes, this guy is awesome. His name is Dustin Bannister. He's actually my nephew, and he has his own production studio called Blue Creek Productions.
Right.
Works with a lot of well-known artists, and he was so gracious to not only find the connection today for me, but also to play for me as well. So.
Good job.
Awesome.
Good job. Well, you know what? I told you, I think I have a new favorite now.
Aww.
Great job. Keep doing what you're doing.
Thank you.
More people should definitely, if they haven't already, they should check you out. Because
Thank you.
Your music, what you're doing is exactly what music and people are supposed to do, and that's touch us.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
You are touching people.
Yes. Oh, thank you.
Awesome.
Like I said, connect with me, message me. I would love to be able to talk to you and not only share music, but share stories and testimonies and you know, maybe get connected to resources that maybe people need. So
offer some hope.
Yeah.
That's right.
Absolutely.
We'll be right back.
Coming up on The Spiel.
We have a lot of customers that suggest things, and we try them out, and we see what happens.
What was it most important for you to tell this film the right way?
Getting it right and handling it with the sensitivity and respect in which it deserved.
The summer travel season is officially here. And any seasoned traveler will tell you, sometimes the journey is all about the stops along the way. Celebrating 50 years of helping you experience the journey. Larry's Trailer Sales, located on Route 148 north of Ziegler, Illinois.
I would encourage all of you to pay it forward and let that random act of kindness define us as a nation.
You're watching The Spiel.
And we are really spieling it in our Southside Lumber Kitchen today, brought to you by Prairie Farms. You know what? I almost want to skip the whole segment and just start eating.
Me too. Just give them the microphone, Mel yeah. and Chris from Primo's Pizza, and let them talk about it as we're eating. I think it's a great idea.
Have to.
Chris, did you get up this morning and get all this done?
We got up early. It didn't take long to get it done.
Yeah. So. Okay. All right. Well, hey, what goes into deciding? I think anymore on a pizza, anything goes.
Yes, I believe that's true. We have a variety. Mm-hmm. For instance, here's a Reuben with sauerkraut and corned beef and Thousand Island.
Here?
No, this one. This one's a Reuben.
This one's mine. Okay. It's got Angie's name on the front. All right.
Man. We have a lot of customers that suggest things, and we try them out, and we see what happens.
This is artichoke?
That's actually a chicken bacon ranch.
Good job.
You were close. It's okay.
You're killing it. I mean, you are killing it. You know, here's the other thing. As soon as you guys walked in, everybody said, yeah, this pizza, their cheese is amazing. So is that one reason you're sought out as well, as you have a really high grade, great cheese?
We have a special five blend cheese.
Okay.
That originally when we opened, no one in Southern Illinois used it. And I know there's a couple of places out there that do use it now.
Are they copying you?
They ripped you off.
They must be.
They might be, they yes.
Wow.
But I usually don't tell people what all five cheeses are, mm-hmm. you know, to kind of keep it a secret. Because the cheese is our centerpiece. Most pizza places put their cheese on the bottom. Mm-hmm. We put it on top, and that's what gives the pizza the extra flavor.
Nice.
Now, are those dessert pizzas?
Yes.
Let's go through those.
We have this is a blueberry cheesecake, mm-hmm. and we have a cinnamon apple and a peach pie.
Yes.
Our cheesecakes are one of our newest, and we also have a strawberry and a cherry cheesecake and an Oreo cheesecake. It's not your traditional cheesecake because, you know, it's cooked, it goes through the oven, it's a cheesecake base, and then we put our other fruit toppings on top.
What seems to be the most popular pizza?
That's tough, isn't it? Especially with these creations.
You could always say the plain old pepperoni is most popular.
Boring.
Well, but kids, man, that's their thing, you know? They don't want you to jack up their pizza with all sorts of stuff.
You know what's so really cool? When you're little, you like the pepperoni only.
Oh, yeah.
But then
when you grow up, you're like, whatever you got, put it on it. It'll be great. So did you think that you would be so successful in the world of creating pizzas and you chose the right road there for your profession or what?
Well, I wasn't sure. I mean, I've been in the business for about 12 years, but been with Primo's for 5 and no, I love it. Okay. And I love food and we like experimenting, so.
I like her.
It works out.
I like food. That's good. Good deal.
Okay, the sandwich, what is it?
The sandwich is, our sandwiches are unique. Mm-hmm. Usually when you order a sub sandwich, you get lettuce and tomato and all this condiments added to it.
Sure.
We believe our sandwiches are so good, we don't have that. This is a turkey, ham, and bacon.
Okay.
And cheese.
Oh,
and that's
it's
it.
Delicious.
See, I love that. I don't
keep
like
it
that
simplified.
Other stuff.
We don't carry mayonnaise. We don't carry lettuce. We don't. You know, people ask for it, and we just tell them it's so good you won't need it.
You won't need it.
That's
awesome. That's awesome.
And the biggest thing about our menu, you see all these specialty pizzas. Mm-hmm. They come in calzone and sub form.
Oh.
So if you don't want a Reuben pizza, have a Reuben sub. And we have over 18 different specialties.
Wow. You know, why go anywhere else? I mean, you've got everything you need.
Everything.
Mm-hmm. That's great.
When we moved to Energy, that's a big Italian town.
Yeah.
And Italian beef was a big product in that town.
Okay.
So we came out with our own Italian beef sub, but now we're taking subs and creating pizzas out of them. We have an Italian beef pizza and a calzone also, which is unique. You know, we haven't seen one yet down here.
Nice.
So.
I love
nice,
that.
Nice, nice, nice. Yeah.
I love that.
Meeting a need. If they ask for it, you will deliver it.
Yes.
Okay. No pun intended on that. You've definitely got a recipe for success because people are talking.
Yes.
You had to expand. You had to find another location. I mean, before you know it, you'll be in Chicago, like, charging people a lot
No,
more
but don't make all these. Don't make these.
So, yeah. Good stuff. Good stuff. All right, Julie, what else you got? Because it's time to eat it.
I have nothing because I want to dive.
All right. We'll be right back.
We work very well together. He was an actor first. More importantly, more than anything, when it comes to these stories, he cares and he's committed to getting it right.
I'm Kim Matroka, the CEO of Christopher Rural Health Planning Corporation. I'd like to thank all of you for being here today for our groundbreaking for our new building.
You don't understand how important it is to have those key locations where healthcare can be provided. we want to say a special thank you.
What our goals are to build healthier communities and to serve the people. Today we're going to celebrate the 43,000 patients that Christopher Rural Health Planning Corporation takes care of across Southern Illinois.
But when I first came to Dr. Hughes, I was losing my teeth. He was one of the few people I could find could actually work on this problem that I had.
Implant dentistry is truly one of the most revolutionary advancements that's occurred in dentistry.
And I always felt my health and well-being were priority to him.
Every patient has an individualized treatment plan or care. Not one solution is appropriate for every type of patient that comes in.
I've come here almost a decade. I think he's that good.
To find out more about the Spiel or even watch past episodes, visit spielon.com.
Hey, how many times you run this thing?
Boston 18, 43 overall.
That's impressive, boss.
Hi, everybody. I'm Tim Estiloz with the Spiel on Entertainment, and I'm here at the special Boston red carpet premiere of the new film Patriots Day, a story of great courage and resilience in the wake of one of Boston's darkest days.
They say 500,000 people watch the Boston Marathon here in New England.
Hey!
Baby.
Hey, you behaving yourself?
As you were putting this film together, certainly you had to bear in mind telling the story sensitively and bearing many of the victims in mind. How much of a challenge was that for you to walk that fine line?
A challenge, but not as challenging as you might think, in as much as Pete and Mark were 100% committed to respecting any one or any group's sensitivities.
Mark, as a hometown boy, what was it most important for you to tell this film the right way?
Getting it right and handling it with the sensitivity and respect in which it deserved. But, you know, I think, you know, being a hometown guy and seeing how my community responded and how proud they made me to be a Bostonian, you know, we're committed to getting it right.
How does it feel for you to have put this film together and have it debut in this town right now?
You know, we are so appreciative of the love and the honesty and the warmth that we've been greeted with by the folks who were directly involved in the marathon bombing, from law enforcement to EMTs to the firefighters to the hospital workers, and particularly the survivors, people like Patrick and Jessica Downs. We appreciate so much them opening their hearts and their lives to us. We hope that they feel that we've done them a solid and that they feel proud of this film. We're all a little nervous, but we're also very excited, and we're very proud of the film, but we're really proud of the city of Boston and this community for letting us in.
The New York Post is reporting a 20-year-old Saudi national has been charged. Can you confirm?
They jammed an enormous amount of detailed information into this film that happened over 4 days in just a two-hour film. I was shocked at how close they were to what really happened.
Does it capture the spirit of Boston?
Captures the spirit of Boston, the tenaciousness of the investigators and the courageousness of the officers who were out there, and mostly the people.
We've got to decide who's running this, and we have to decide quickly.
It's terrorism. We'll take it.
As you're watching a film of this nature, having lived through it, when you're watching it on the screen, what kind of memories or thoughts come to mind?
Heart-wrenching memories. First of all, reliving the horror that the victims and the survivors lived through that day. That's my primary emotion, is just it's difficult to watch some aspects of it because it was so tragic. But I think the movie portrays those situations very accurately, very graciously, with a great deal of empathy towards the victims and the survivors and the law enforcement officers who worked so hard that week. And I think it well portrays the assistance that was provided to us by members of the American public, by people like Danny Meng and David Henneberry. We couldn't have broken the case without them. We said all week in our press conferences that week that it would be tips from the American public that would help us break this case. And that's what happened.
And let's get an evidence grid started right over there.
Clock is ticking. The world is watching.
The suspect seen on the surveillance cameras. Two bombers.
We gotta find these guys before they do this to someone else.
Why is this the right time for this film in your mind?
No, well, we debated, you know, is it too soon? But you think about what happened in Cairo on Sunday and what continues to happen all over the world, it's not soon enough. The message of love and hope and unity needs to be out there. It needs to be seen and heard by everybody.
Even though on the red carpet the focus is clearly on some of the stars, we're also seeing some of the actual survivors from the marathon bombing. This is the kind of thing that makes Patriots Day oh so very emotional.
The representation, you know, the characters with our names, I was more than okay with it. But the other parts, they're hard. You know, it's hard to see people building a bomb, you know, on camera when you know what that bomb then did to you and your husband, you know? So it's hard to say something like that is good. You know, I guess powerful comes to mind, something like that. But tonight, for us, we're both so anxious because we want to know what our co-survivors think. We want to know what the city thinks who supported us from day one. Like, to us, it's like if it doesn't resonate with them, those are kind of the only critics that really matter.
We can't have our citizens on the streets with all these threats. Every inch of this city is getting searched. We're shutting it down.
Have become part of Boston. So through your words, through your eyes, what is it about the spirit of Boston that comes through in this film that helped us survive the marathon bombing?
You know, Boston is in a special time. My man.
I'm good.
Boston is a wonderful town where people had a wonderful spirit. And I think that was the main key for all of us to bounce back and go back to normal in a short period of time. You know, I think New England people is special. It's very special, very special to me, you know. And this is a place that I call home also, you know what I'm saying? So I think there's wonderful people around with unbelievable spirit, and this city gonna be always able to bounce back from anything that happened.
This is not a film about terrorism. This is a film about love. This is a film about good beating evil.
What is it about you as an actor that you translate as a director when you're on the set?
You know, I know how hard it is to act and how, you know, people think it's a lot easier than it is, but when those cameras are pointed at you and you realize that it's going to be forever, people can get tight and nervous and, you know, insecure, and that's normal, and I try and relax people as much as I can because I've been there before. Thank
you, guys. You've done three films with Peter Berg. What's it like working with him that makes you gel so well?
We work very well together. He was an actor first. More importantly, more than anything, when it comes to these stories, he cares, and he's committed to getting it right.
A lot of law enforcement officers like yourself, you're very private, you're just doing your job. So what's it like to see someone portraying you on the big screen?
It's very humbling. You know, it's something you never think is going to happen. You know, day in and day out, you know, just a regular guy, and you never picture somebody's going to be portraying you in a movie and, you know, using your name in a movie and everything else.
You thinking about doing some more acting, maybe?
Hey, I'm a free man now. Who knows?
That's right. You've got some free time on your hands now.
There you go. You never know.
Well, the stars are inside and the red carpet's about to be rolled up. But that doesn't mean that it's over for you. You be sure to go and check out Patriots Day coming to a theater very soon. For the Spiel on Entertainment, I'm Tim Estiloz.
What I saw today, good versus evil, love versus hate, there's only one weapon you have to fight back with. It's love. Wrap our arms around each other. I don't think there's any way that they could ever win.
I'm getting ready.
In the store?
Clean up aisle 6.
Have you seen these bathroom displays?
At Southside Lumber, our professional design team can help you create the bathroom you've always wanted. Call or stop by and see for yourself.
This is my dream bathroom.
More than just lumber. Southside Lumber.
Now, you can do more with less. Introducing the GPX Anchor, the water-based marker tough enough to ride on just about any surface. And since it's water-based, that means less solvents. That means it's safer for you, safer for the environment, and unregulated for all modes of shipping. And when it comes to performance, the Anchor is every bit as tough and long-lasting as the GPX Classic. So when you need a water-based marker that will hold and last, pick up the GPX Anchor by Diagraph.
You're watching The Spiel.
Another huge show, and look what we have on our set. Wasn't that fun to make?
It was fun.
Now I feel like I can be artistic and make flowers. That was easy. She made it look easy.
She did. And we do that on this show. We make everything. What?
Do I have pizza?
I was wondering if I had some.
Little artichoke right here.
That's ridiculous.
Reuben.
You know what? There are so many talented people in this area, whether they're making pizzas or flowers or, you know, performing these songs that will change your life. Just being on the Spiel will do that. So look us up.
It'll change your life.
It will change your life forever. It really will.
Hey, I heard about something a while ago.
What is it?
What is the new thing where you can go, hey, Siri, or hey, Google?
No, who is it? It's Alexa. And I don't think you have to pick it up. Alexa, like, can be across the room, like, Alexa, order me something, or, you know, Alexa, so, be my friend, because I'm on
from across
whatever,
the room,
you know,
it can hear it. Wow,
she's just there to, like, do. Can you can, like, program her to turn lights off?
No way.
Yes. Is there just one? It's Alexa.
Now, how does that work?
What?
All your appliances connect through Wi-Fi, and they talk to Alexa.
And this is an app.
It's an actual piece of hardware.
It's hardware, okay.
It has to be on your main computer.
It could be named Alexa.
It runs by itself.
What's the others?
Echo and Amazon.
Echo and Amazon and Alexa. Alexa's just a pretty name. You would much rather be talking
that
to Alexa.
That would freak me out if I said, hey, turn my oven on, and my oven came on.
That is happening all around you.
What's happening?
What if they turned your oven on and you weren't home?
Oh.
What if I didn't want my oven on?
Perhaps you don't order it if you don't want it on.
I'm staying away from her.
Yeah, does she make you nervous?
Well, she does, but these don't. And I have.
You program.
I program the flowers. Y'all don't believe me, do you? No one believes me.
You don't know about technology.
Ready?
Yeah.
Ready? Okay. Hey, flowers. Play George Strait.
I got some oceanfront property.
Oh,
stop.
That's ridiculous.
How about that right there?
That is the beauty of post-production and television.
Got one more, ready?
What you got?
Hey, flowers.
Why are you talking so seductively to the flower? Like,
it's a male plant.
Oh, it is?
Hey, flowers.
I don't know where this is going.
Will you play Celebration?
Okay, let's stop. Let's just stop. Okay, Matt, what's your code so I can get in? You got anything else with your flower? Are you guys going to make out anymore?
Hang on.
Can we get on with it?
Wait, say something to me.
Say something to me.
I can't tell her that.
No. Okay, listen, our word today, oof.
I can't see it.
Thaumaturgy.
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 See? Thaumaturgy.
Thaumaturgy.
Turgy?
Thaumaturgy.
Thaumaturgy. Nope.
Turgy.
Turgy. Thaumaturgy.
Okay, and it means?
The performance of miracles, it's magic, boo. All right, you ready?
No, it's filled with thaumaturge.
One, two, three, four. Four syllables.
It's filled with thaumaturge.
Okay, got it.
Sorry. All right, ready?
Okay, thaw.
Ma.
Ter.
G. That was good.
Thaumaturgy. That's
thaumaturgy.
It.
Thaumaturgy. Wait, what's the flower say?
Whatever. All right, listen, we're not going to put you through any more excruciating pain. We'll see you next week.
The song is called Wherever You May Be. Look at me, standing knee deep in hope. I'd give anything if I could figure out just how to let you go. look at you, so brave and so strong. There's not any other place I'd rather you be than where you belong. So go ahead and let go of my hand and walk into the life you must begin. But call and ride when you can. Settle for nothing and stand up for something you believe in. Try and don't forget to dream. And remember, my prayers will find you wherever you. Look at the time and how fast it's passed us by. Every moment with you I will hang on to with all my life. So please believe that when we say goodbye, you're always in my heart and call and ride when you can. Settle for nothing and stand up for something you believe in. Try and don't forget to dream. And remember, my prayers will find you wherever you. Though age may lead to change, the years cannot take away my love for you. You. So call and ride when you can. Settle for nothing and stand up for something you believe in. Try and don't you forget to dream. And remember, my prayers will find you wherever you may be. And remember, mama's prayers, they're gonna find you wherever you.
Hey, Flowers, play Man, I Feel Like a Woman.
Come on, Matt.
Mm.